Sri Guruvyo Namaha children, today's class we are going to learn about insectivores. Last class we have learned about the parasitic plants and saprophytic plants. Now today's class we are going to learn about insectivorous plants. So what is meant by insectivorous plants? The plants that get nutrition. The plants that get nutrition by trapping. The plants that get nutrition by trapping and digesting animals, mainly insects. See the plants. The plant that gets some of their nutrients. So the plant that gets nutrients by trapping insects and animals are called insectivorous plants. It is called insectivorous plants. So now listen. What is mean by insectivorous plants? Plants that get some of their nutrients by trapping and digesting animals, mainly insects, are called what? Insectivorous plants. Why even they are green color they can prefer, but in the soil where they are growing, the plants where they are growing, the soils are deficient in certain nutrition like nitrogen. So the minerals, the food requires minerals. So one of the minerals from for the plant is nitrogen. So some the plant, the insectivorous plants grow in a soil, they are deficient of the nutrition nitrogen. So they want to get the nutrition, to get fulfill the nutrition or the requirement for the growth of the plant, they trap the insects. They trap the insects. They catch. Trap means what? They catch the insects and digest. And from the by the digestion of the insects, by the digestion of the insects, they absorb nitrogen, the nutrition called one nitrogen. So the example of the insectivorous plants are sundew. Example is sundew and bladderwort and Venus flytrap. So what is, children, what is meant by insectivorous plants? Plants. So now read once again, what is insectivorous plants? Plants that get some of their nutrition by trapping. Trapping means by catching. You also have mouse trap to catch the rat. Understand? So like that, they are trapping, they are catching and digesting even the small animals like frog, lizard. They can catch small animals like lizard as well as frog, and insects are called what? Insectivorous. Why they want to eat insects? Even though they are green, they can prefer their food, but the plant they grow in a soil, they are deficient in some nutrition, certain nutrition like nitrogen. So the insectivorous plants grow in a soil, they are deficient in nitrogen. So in order to get the nutrition, the plants are trapping the insect and digesting. By the digestion, they are getting nitrogen from the insects as well as small animals. So by digesting the insects or the small animals, they are getting the required nutrition is nitrogen. So that such type of plants are called insectivorous plant. Now you can see that here the name of the plant is called sun dew. So you can see that the dew drops are there. It is very attractive. By the attraction of the plant, if the insects are sitting, now see one bee is catching. So if by the attraction the insects are sitting, the plants can trap. The plants trap and digest the insects. And digest by digesting, they are getting the nutrition. What is the nutrition they are getting from the insects? Children, tell me. Now, what type of nutrition they are getting? What nutrition? Nitrogen. Why they want to trap from nitrogen from insects? Because the plants which are growing in the soil are deficient in nitrogen. Next, see, this one is called sundew. See that openings. The openings are there. So in that, if the plants are sitting inside the leaf, means what? They are going to close like this. If they are sitting in between leaves, after sitting they are going to close, and by closing they are going to digest the insects. By digestion they are getting the required nutrition called one nitrogen. This is one of the plant called Venus flytrap. This is called what? Venus flytrap. Now you see here one more plant, the very attractive and the fluid like fluid inside the plant. So if the plants are coming and by the attraction of the color, if they are sitting and they fall into that fluid, they fall into the fluid, they cannot able to escape. They cannot able to escape. So by this, they are digesting the food. By this, they are digesting the food. So by this, the insectivorous plants, they get nutrition where the soil is deficient in nitrogen. So these are all about the insectivorous plants. Children, read once again. What is insectivorous plants? Plants that get some of their nutrition by trapping and digesting animals, mainly insects, are called insectivorous plants. So now you can see that how they are catching. See, the plants are very attractive in nature. By that attraction of the plant, the insects are trapped into that plant. And the next one, symbiotic plant. What is meant by symbiotic? Symbiosis. Symbiosis means a type of relationship. A type of relationship where two or more organisms associate. Associate means they can be combined each other. So with each other, mutually beneficial manner. So they are going to some benefit from each other. So if the two plants are exist in the same area, they are going to get benefit from each other. Such type of plants are called, or the such type of relation between existing, such type of relationship existing between the plants are called symbiotic plants. What is symbiosis? Symbiosis is a type of relationship where two or more organisms associate with each other mutually beneficial manner. So both are going to get benefit by each other while living together. So such type of relation exists in the plants are called symbiotic plants. Now see that in the symbiotic plants, the symbiotic plants are rhizobium. Rhizobium present in the roots of the leguminous plant. The leguminous plants are the symbiosis plant. So the leguminous plants contain the root noodles, root nodes. Now you see that the beads like structure. See this type of some plants in the root, the bead like structure, the bead like structure are called rhizobium. These are called what? Rhizobium. So these in this rhizobium, they are storing what? The nitrogen. The plants are storing excess nitrogen, and this nitrogen is going to be converted into nitrogenous compound and used by the plant. So if the plant is growing in that area, means that nitrogenous compound can be used by the other plant living on that area. So the symbiosis means what? Mutually beneficial. They are each mutually means what? Each other. Sharing between, in between. So they are going to get, but the leguminous plants as the root nodes. That root nodes contain the rhizobium contain what? Rich in nitrogen. So one of the essential nutrition for the growth of the plant is nitrogen. So they are going to get the plants around this. The plant, those who are living around this also, they are going to get nitrogen compound. So this is called what? Symbiosis. So one more thing is called symbiosis. So here, this is also a type of symbiotic plant, lichens, bacterium. So this bacterium also supply nutrition. You can see this type in the plants. Some plant their color algae can be grown on this. These are usually you can see wherever in the plants. So this is also one of the symbiotic plant. You can see this here also. The plant, some of the algae-like structure is growing. Is along the plant. So they are giving nutrition, they are sharing nutrition. If the parasite means what? They are absorbing nutrition. See the difference between the symbiotic plants and the parasitic plants. Here the plants also growing along that, but here they are sharing the nutrition between these two plants. So here also see this, these are all not the parasitic. Parasitic plants means what? They are absorbing nutrition from the host plants, but they are also growing along the other plant, but they are sharing the nutrition between these two. They are sharing the lichen. The yellow color plants are called lichens. They are rich in nitrogen, so they are giving nitrogen to the other plant. So this type of plants are called symbiotic plants. So in the heterotrophic nutrition, we have learned about one, parasitic plant, saprophytic plants, insectivorous plants, and the symbiotic plants. So we will see the next, the replacement of the nutrition, that we will see in the next class. Thank you, children.